Drive Time with John Warnett.
Call 0800 756 1111.
BBC Radio Kent.
Yes, good evening. Now, a husband and wife and four of their children are having to live in a tent in Ramsgate after failing health meant they could not afford the private rented house they were living in. Joanne Foster, who's 33, and a 32-year-old husband, Daniel, who's 32, were both working and lived with their six children. But Joanne developed arthritis and couldn't work, and Daniel developed problems with his chest and had to give up work as a French polisher. Now the family is living in a tent in Daniel's mother's back garden. Let's speak to Joanne, first of all. Joanne, very good evening. Thank you for joining us. I mean, it's just starting to get a bit nippy, isn't it? How cold is it in the tent?
Well, first thing in the morning, it's absolutely freezing. Trying to get the children up and ready for school is unbelievable. It's hard enough when we're in a house, let alone in a tent. We've all got quilts, got layers and layers on us, but it's just not, it's not suitable, Steve, for children, or, well, for anyone really living in a tent at this time, especially with the colder mornings and the colder evenings.
Yeah, now, I mean, people listening to this will think, hang on a minute, you've got children, you've got four children living with you in the tent. Surely you must be a priority for the council to house, aren't you?
Well, apparently not. I've done everything that the council wanted me to do, well, us as a family did, and I spoke to my housing officer once at the beginning of the year. They didn't have my up-to-date email or phone number till about 3 weeks ago. It's like they don't want to know. They just can't be bothered to help.
I think they're saying that you have intentionally made yourself homeless. How do they work that out?
Oh, that's exactly why I put an appeal in to obviously change the decision, because I said to them, for a couple of years we've been working and we've been paying the rent and we've been living happily, and we've always done private renting from, well, since I was 19 years old. We've never gone to the council for a house. We've never been offered a house.
Right.
So when we need them, it's kind of like they don't want to know. And it's my children as well. It's their human rights, and they just kind of don't want to even look at us at the moment.
How long have you been in the tent?
5 weeks tomorrow.
Right. So just to recap, you were renting a house privately, and then you both got sick effectively and had to give up your jobs, and obviously you couldn't pay the rent then.
Yeah, no, obviously at the time we had the internet and the Sky, like the luxuries that we could never really afford before. So everything, including the rent, just piled on top.
Yeah.
Why not? It just seemed to all come at the same time, but once you're in arrears, it's kind of hard to try and get out of arrears, especially when you go back onto benefits and you've got six growing children. It was just a kind of no-win kind of thing.
But isn't the benefit system supposed to be a safety net? Surely they would pay your rent, wouldn't they?
They started to pay the rent, but it was just trying to catch up with the rent arrears.
Is that because your benefit took what? I mean, did it take long?
It can take up to 6 weeks. I think it was. And obviously, we had to come off of work and tax credits, so we had to go on to other benefits.
Yeah.
So it just took so long to sort it all out. And then we was borrowing money just to feed the children. It was just such a horrible time.
Well, also on the line is Thanet District Councillor and Labour County Councillor Karen Constantine. Karen, good evening to you.
Hello there.
I just can't believe this. If you've got six children, four of them living with you at the moment in a tent, that you're not a priority.
No, it's just unbelievable to me. I've been in touch with Joanne now for the past month, and we're struggling to make any headway with either the district council or with social services to identify a solution. I mean, certainly these six children need to be together as a family. They need to have a roof over their head. They need to be safe and secure. I mean, this is just indicative of a completely broken housing market. The money that Joanne and her husband Daniel get is nowhere near enough to enable them to find and afford a suitable
privately rented one. So, but
it's just impossible.
But have you got any sympathy with Thanet District Council? Because let's be honest, trying to find a house for these people, it would have to be a fairly substantial building, wouldn't it?
Well, I mean, Joanne and Daniel are very flexible. They're happy with a three-bedroom house. or a four-bedroom house, that would suit them absolutely fine. Those properties are around. Thanet District Council do need to take action now. This family are a priority. We cannot have, in this day and age, six children sleeping in a tent. Mm. I think it's really that simple. And I do have some sympathy with Thanet District Council when we've had nothing but cut after cut from central government, and this is where it ends up, a family sleeping in a tent. Yeah. That's a terrible indictment of this society.
So, Joanne, now your benefit's coming through now. I suppose you're not in receipt of housing benefit anymore, are you?
No,
or are you?
No, not at the moment.
Because you haven't got a house, obviously.
No. Yeah. And but they changed all our benefits over to Universal Credit. So
right.
That was just before we've moved into the tent. So we have to obviously wait another 5 weeks just for any kind of money to come through.
So, but what I'm wondering is, if with the benefit system, you're getting your benefits now, is it not possible that you could now afford a private house on the housing benefit that you would get?
Well, to be honest, we have been looking, and I can't even get a foot in the front door to view a property because guarantors earning four times the amount of the rent, which I looked at a house yesterday, that was $3,800 that someone's got to be earning a month. Wow. And it's just, but no one wants obviously six children in a property, which I can understand that, especially if it's your own property. You don't want that many children, but as I said to the council, I'll take a two-bedroom house.
Well, anything. I mean, whether they're allowed to do that or not, I don't know. Karen, I mean, who's responsible for this? Because somebody needs their heads knocking together at Thanet District Council. I know this is a difficult situation, but we cannot have children living in tents.
No, we certainly can't. And I think the responsibility rests with Thanet District Council. I think there are those properties out there. There's not loads of them. I know that the staff working for Thanet District Council are very stretched, but I think we've got to come up with a solution for this family. Okay. Passing them between Thanet District Council and social services and back again is not a solution. The nights are going to get colder. One of these children is bound to get ill. They'll all get ill then. This is no way for a family to try and exist in this day and age. It just simply is wrong.
Well, I hope broadcasting this story, because I think most people listening will be appalled at it, that maybe something will happen. Let's hope so. Joanne, I hope it's sorted soon. And thank you to the councillor as well. Karen Constantine. We'll keep you updated. If we hear anything, if anything changes, we will let you know.